So in this section, let's start looking at fluid shifts. Now before we look into what happens in microgravity, let's just consider what happens to us here on Earth. We stand up straight, and we know that due to gravity, a lot of the blood pulls into the dependent parts, and especially in the lower extremities, so much that at the level of the heart, let's just say if the pressures there are on average 100 millimeters of mercury, in the head it can be a lot less, let's just say about 80, and it can be definitely be a lot more down in the feet. And we have mechanisms in the capillary bed and in the arterioles to maintain tone and to keep the blood flowing so that all of it at least doesn't pull and just distends the vessels until they rupture. So that certainly doesn't happen under normal circumstances. And now we go lie supine. And we are now lying down. What happens now? And we think, well, the same sort of thing should now happen when we go into microgravity. So what's going to happen? This is an enormous pool of blood which now gets redistributed. And what we would note immediately, if for a 70 kilogram man, if you had about 75 milliliter per beat ejection fraction, as the ventricles contract, that's the ejection fraction, that is the volume of blood that gets ejected, it will now go up to about 95 milliliters per beat. Okay, because that heart distends. And what is going to happen? Well, there's baroreceptors, and we spoke about the baroreceptors. They're going to notice, well, there's more pressure around, there's more distension. So what are we going to have with those baroreceptors? Well, first of all, there's going to be some sympathetic reflex, and the first thing you'll notice is that the heart rate goes down, because we're going to have some form of cardiac output, and remember, that'll be my beats per minute, my milliliters per beat and my beats per minute. So that'll give me milliliters per minute. So it's actually going to be liters because it goes over 1,000. Okay, let's just do that mathematics. So cardiac output is going to be the stroke volume times the heart rate. If you think about that, just a bit of simple mathematics, stroke volume, so that's going to be milliliters per beat times beats per minute. So those two are going to cancel, and I'm left with milliliters per minute, my cardiac output. So you can't, it can't just increase out of bounds, this cardiac output. So as this goes up, this is going to tend to fall. And do that for yourself. If you're on a treadmill, or you've just jogged, or you've just been on a training bike, and you've got a heart rate monitor on, you'll have certain beats per minute. Now, just as it's quite high, 130, 140, 150, go lie down to do some push-ups or sit-ups. And look on your heart rate monitor. You'll notice that your heart rate comes down quite a bit. You are lowering this part just to compensate so that your cardiac output doesn't go too high. So you're going to see this decrease in heart rate. And then through the other sympathetic pathways, specifically to the kidneys, you're going to have suppression of your renin, angiotensin, aldosterone system. Okay, you're definitely going to have the renin levels go down and the downstream effects of that. Okay, as you try and compensate for this volume that is now pushed into the central section, you're also going to have a decrease in your antidiuretic hormone, central antidiuretic hormone through reflex pathways. Antidiuretic hormone that's going to keep volume back, but now you lower that, okay? And because of the distension in the heart itself, you're going to increase your ANP, ANF, depending on where you live, natriuretic peptide. Okay, so that's going to increase, and all of this together should then give you a higher urinary output. As you now try and get rid of this excess volume that is now being pushed centrally as you lie down, you're going to have to get this sodium and water, as water follows it, is going to be excreted due to all, at least to these mechanisms. So that's what happens when you lie down for a while, and it's tested. We can do to simulate on Earth, have people bed bound for some considerable time, and you notice all these things. But does this indeed happen in microgravity? That's the question.